Hitomi. I think I know what happened 18 years ago. You three were close. You, Monika, and Renju. Monika was murdered. You and Renju found the body in the mountains. And you brought it back to the cold storage warehouse. And my guess is so Sejima killed Monika. I've seen inside his head before, using this machine.
I see. If you know that much, then there's no point in hiding it anymore. I'll tell you the truth.
Wait, you're going to see So?
Yes. I want to talk to him in person.
No, you can't.
Why not? Are you worried about my body? You don't have to worry about that. I'm totally fine.
But your stomach is still...
My doctor told me that's normal. Your stomach doesn't go down right away after giving birth.
I'm not worried about your body. I don't know how to explain it. So doesn't care about you. And especially not your child.
I haven't told him about giving birth. He contacted me for the first time in a while.
So that's why.
He wants to know about the baby.
He must be panicking. If anyone ever finds out his mistress had his baby, his political career would be over.
It's not like it was an affair.
His wife passed away after giving birth to his son, right?
It would still be a big scandal. He impregnated a girl who just graduated high school. Don't you see how that looks? He knew how the public would take it. That's why he gave you the money to deal with it. There's no way he'll accept that child.
It's okay. I told him that I won't cause any trouble. But could you take care of the baby? Just for a little bit? I'll be right back.
Fine. But take this with you, just in case. It's a GPS transmitter. Just to be extra safe.
I really don't think I'll need it. But okay, if it'll make you feel better.
I don't know what Monika saw in So. She said he was kind and loyal, that he wanted to change Japan. But I didn't understand any of it. He tried to convince her to break up with him so many times. She never listened. And it ended in tragedy. What happened next, you already know. Neither Renju or I saw it happen, so I don't know how much of this is accurate. But we could guess what happened. He told her to move overseas. He said he'd pay for everything. Date, you said that Monica was killed by So, right? But that's not true. Monica was killed by Saito Sejima, the son of So and his late wife. Saito was 12 at the time.
12?
Yes.
But why would a little boy do that?
I don't know. I can't imagine. Renju told me.
But you said he wasn't there.
He heard some of this from the Kumakuras. Renju had connections with them.
How did the Kumakuras know?
So told them. So contacted his friend, the chairman of the Kumakuras. He asked him to dispose of the body and left the scene with Saito.
The incident was 18 years ago. That means the chairman was Rohan, not Moma.
Rohan went to the scene of the crime?
Yes, with some of his men. Again, neither Renju or I saw this. We were just waiting at my house for Monika to return. But she never came back. We tried to call her cell, but it didn't connect. But then, we saw movement on the GPS.
The GPS Renju gave to Monika?
Yes. At first, we thought she was on her way home. But we saw the GPS getting further and further away from the city. Renju and I got nervous, and we decided to follow it.
What about the baby?
We couldn't take the baby with us, so Renju gave the baby to the mob doctor he trusted.
Those are Kumakura men.
We didn't dare move. We couldn't speak. We were barely breathing. We could only watch as it all unfolded. I knew what the hole was for. But I couldn't move. Couldn't do anything. I remember my heart beating so fast. Before long,
we good here?
Yeah. Cover her.
Just a minute.
Covered Monika's body, then left. Renju and I ran over and dug up the grave with a tree branch. What we saw.
We can't. Not yet.
Why not?
You don't know who those guys are. They would do anything to keep this hidden. I've seen it happen myself. I know what they're capable of. Anyway, think about it. Why would they do this? They thought Monika and her baby were going to be trouble. Monica's stomach was still pretty big. I don't think they know that she gave birth already. What do you think they'd do if they found out? They would take her and kill her too. And then, they'd come for us. They'd make it look like we disappeared. All of us would be gone.
Renju convinced me. He knew more about the dirty underbelly of society than anyone. He knew when something couldn't be handled by the police. He said that they would do anything to kill the child. And I believed him. We had to protect Monica's baby. We had to, no matter what.
Okay, I understand.
I decided to trust him. We couldn't leave Monica's body in the forest. We cleaned her up and took her to the cold storage warehouse.
This warehouse is owned by Okiura Fishery. My father runs it. But it's not in use right now. They're moving operations to a better area. They're actually looking for buyers right now. But don't worry, I'll take over the warehouse.
Are you sure?
Yes. Don't worry. I'll keep everyone out. Everyone but you, of course. I'll give you a key. You can come visit anytime you want to see Monica.
Monica, don't worry about the baby. I'll protect her, no matter what. And don't worry about them, either. The people who did this to you, I will never forgive them. I'm sorry, Monica. Sorry. I'm sorry. Monica.
Thank you.
I don't really want to discuss this, but... there's something you need to know. After talking to the Kumakura gang, I found out who killed Monika. So's son, Saito Tsujima.
How? Saito was only...
12 years old.
Why? Why would a little boy do that?
I don't know the motive, but I know it's true. So used his connections with the Kumakuras to cover up for his son. And all of the evidence of this scandal, of course.
I'll never forgive them. So, his son, or the Kumakuras?
I feel the same way. But you can't think about revenge now. You and the baby can't lead a life like that. Just bear with it for now. The opportunity will come. So wait until the right moment, okay? The mob doctor took care of everything. I have the birth certificate, and I even picked up a mother and baby book. It wasn't cheap, but you don't have to worry about it. Just submit the birth certificate, and everything will be taken care of. You look worried.
I feel like... I'm somehow betraying Monika. She was the one who gave birth.
Soon, you won't even be able to think about that. Because a war is about to begin.
A war?
Between you and the baby. You won't get a good night's sleep for a long time. You might even start to resent Monika for all this.
Really?
Anyway, as soon as you submit the certificate, you will officially be her mother. Be sure to raise her responsibly. I'll help. Occasionally.
Occasionally, huh? I was thinking about her name. How about Iris?
Iris?
The goddess of rainbows in Greek mythology? And the colored part of your eye.
And the flower, too.
Right.
I thought it might have something to do with your name, Hitomi.
Not only that. It's also for Monika's name. The kanji for Monika uses the character for love. And Monika reminds me of Monaco, Japanese for eye.
So both names have something to do with the eye.
And eye, which means love, will always be a part of Iris.
So that's how you came up with the name?
Don't you think it's nice?
Iris. Iris. Yeah. I really like it.
And so my life with Iris began. Raising a child was much harder than I expected. Waking up in the middle of the night to change diapers or feed her. Iris wasn't a good sleeper. I had to sing her lullabies to put her to sleep. And I always needed to put her to bed so carefully. It would only take 10 seconds before she'd start crying again. So I had to pick her up, Sing her another lullaby,
then put her back to bed.
After doing this over and over, before I knew it, the morning sun would creep in through the windows. But even with all that, I cherished every single day. My hatred for those responsible never went away. But my hands were full raising Iris. I devoted myself to her. I never thought about anything else. Eventually, my desire for revenge just faded away.